Hello students, and welcome back to the next video of class 9th. In this video I will discuss the remaining topics of session 6 of unit 1. I hope you have watched the previous videos very carefully and understood the topics mentioned in that. If you have not watched till now and haven't done your assignment question, so please do it, then come back to this video. Now let's start with the first topic of this video, that is searching for files using wildcard characters. Wildcard characters are those characters which are used when you want to search any file or folder and you don't know the exact name of that particular file or folder. Then in this case you can use the wildcard characters. These characters are basically of two types. The first one is asterisk and the second one is question mark. We can use these characters in the search box while searching any file or folder. It is normally supported in all the versions of a Windows operating systems. Now let's discuss the first wildcard character, that is asterisk. In some cases this asterisk is also known as star. In case of searching, it is used to replace the whole string or the whole name or the partial name of any file or folder. This character is used for searching any file or folder with the name or the extension of file also. For example, if I will write in the search box that asterisk dot asterisk, then it means all the files of any name and all the files of any extension will be displayed in this case. Let's take some more example. If I remember that the name of the file which I am searching is starts with L, so in this case I will search like L asterisk dot asterisk, means it will search all those files or folders in that particular section where we are searching in such a way that all those files and folders which starts with L with having any extension will be searched in this case. As a result, we will see all the files and folders which starts with L. For example, letter.docs, in this case you can see letter.docs is starts with letter L. The second one is lottery.pptx, means it also starts with L, and locality.txt, which is of notepad file, and it also starts with L. In the next example, if we remember the extension of the file which we are searching, then also we can use asterisk wildcard character. Like in this example, we know that the file which we are searching is of document file, that means the extension of that particular file will be .docx, means docx. Then in this case we will search like asterisk dot docs. In this case all those files in that particular folder which where we are searching, which is of docs extension, will be searched. It doesn't matter what is the name of that particular files which is of docs extension, and it will display all the files of docs extension, whether the name is A, B, C or whatever, but it will display all the docs file because in the place of file name we have written asterisk. Let's combine these two examples in the third example, means if we will search L asterisk dot docs, then the search result will be like all those files which starts with L and the extension of that file will be dot docs. Then it will come to the list of the result. For example, letter dot docs, only this will be displayed. but lottery.pptx and locality.txt will not going to display because it starts with L letter, but the extension is pptx and the second extension is .txt, but we are searching for .docs only. Now the next topic is using wildcard character question mark. In this we will discuss the use of question mark character in searching format. This question mark character is used in the place of single letter or single symbol. For example, in this case, if we don't know the single letter in any file name, then we can use it in the place of that particular missing letter. If we don't remember 5 characters of any file, then in that case we will use 5 question mark in place of that missing letters. In this way we can use this question mark wildcard character. Let's take some examples. In this case, kips question mark dot docs will be searched. That means in the result those files will come whose names are kips 1 dot docs, kips p dot docs, kips f dot docs. Means it will search those files whose names will be kips, and after that the missing letter will come and then dot docs. In the next example, kips question mark and question mark, 3 question mark will be searched with dot docs extension. Then in the result it will give those file names whose file names are kips, after kips 3 letters will be there which we don't know, dot docs. Means it will give those files whose names are like kips 123 dot docs, kips xyz dot docs, kips abc dot docs. This type of file will be searched after searching this keyword. Windows provides us the facility of using both the two wildcard characters at the same time. For example, if we search question mark dot asterisk, then in this case question mark enables us to search only those files who is having only one letter in their names, and dot asterisk will give those results in which the extension of the file who is having only one letter in the name is of any kind of extension. For example, it will give the result like l.docs, r.pptx, e.txt. In these 3 examples we can see, due to question mark in the search, because question mark displays only one letter, it shows only one letter file, and due to dot asterisk it gives the result of all the extension of files who is having one letter in their name. One more example is there in which we can search kips asterisk dot question mark question mark question mark. Means 3 question marks are there. It will display those files who is having kips in the first name, means as a starting name. After that it can be any name like kips 1 2 3 4 5 6 xyz, because asterisk is there. But in case of question mark, because it display only one letter, so it will display only those file whose extension will be of 3 letters only. For example, if we search kips asterisk dot question mark question mark question mark, then it will give the result like kips book dot txt. In this case asterisk replaced book, and txt which is of 3 character replaced question marks. Now one of the finest or simple method of searching any file or folder is that simply go to that folder where the file exists and just type the starting names of any file which you want to search. Once you start typing on the search box, it will start giving the result automatically according to the matching of the letters which you are typing. That's all for this video. In the next video, I will discuss the remaining topics of this session 6.